We go searching for a case of beer that wasn't 3-2.
Not 3-2.
He used to drive around town in an old 1960 Corvair. Him and all his friends, they called him the BGD. But when I asked him what those three initials stood for, he said, Bartlesville beer, drink or something, that's what it means. Raise hell, drink beer, that's all there is to do around here. They get your kicks, chasing chicks, well, we do it every day of the year. He said, I'm one of these days, I'm gonna leave this town, and you won't.
That, ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, non-fluid gender binary unicorn Pop-Tart toaster toothpaste. If I missed anybody, sorry. Is 1100 Springs off of Bruton, Texas, and the name of the song is Raise Hell, Drink Beer. Okay, I can get behind that. Raising hell part isn't going to happen anymore. I'm getting a little long in the tooth for that shit. But, oh, beautiful, frothy, white head. A little on the cloudy side. Nice golden orange color. This, ladies and gentlemen, is another one from the pandemic series. That's what I'm going to call them. I'll see if I can find some more that are reflective of, bad things that have happened to society. Black Plague, Tony Hawps, with a P. Birdhouse IPA, although Tony is involved with this, they make some really bitchin' artwork. I love these guys. We are sitting at 47.6. That puts us in the sweetness window. The generally approved 44 to 48, unless otherwise specified, degrees. And, of course, this is America, so those degrees are in Fahrenheit. You metric guys can figure that shit out on your own, because I give up. Shouldn't it be 0 to 212 that every degree in the middle should be? Come on, work with me here. 2.12 degrees? Maybe I got that wrong. I give up. Too fucking hot. Just make shit up. That's what I do. I make shit up from now on. That's why we have Metric Thursday, which is my Friday. So I said, fuck it. Make it up. Metric Friday is my day. Done. Anyway. Let's raise some hell and drink some beer, folks. I guess the opinion meter or whatever is still out, the court of public opinion is still out on whether or not this disease is going to wipe us all out and revert humanity back to the Black Plague ages, the basically I would say Iron Age. There's enough guys that can still forge and stuff, or whether the change in numbers that keeps coming up, because as they identify more cases the death toll drops. I think it's now 0.7%. Flu is 1.4 to 1.8. Just saying, the shit I see on the news. Frontline guy, dude. I told you how many I've survived, and there are some I can't even friggin' remember anymore. Anyway, here's to us, my friends. Remember, memento mori. You're gonna die just like everyone else. Live your best life. So, nice and citrusy. Really, really hard citrus in this. About this brew, the hops are Simcoe, Amarillo, Citra, and Centennial. The malts are Two Row and White Wheat. Black Plague Brewing presents another smooth beer. I will be the judge of that. This collaboration with Birdhouse and Tony Hawk. I don't know what Birdhouse is. Yeah, I'm an old guy. I don't know any. I know who Tony Hawk is. He was around the fucking 80s. Manifested into an incredibly smooth beer full of juicy hop flavors and low bitterness. Low bitterness is always good. Brewed with Simcoe and Amarillo hops for a resinous pine foundation, balanced with an outstanding aroma of orange citrus. Hints of fresh grapefruit from the Citra and Centennial used in the dry hop. Okay, well, it sounds pretty damn interesting. Oh, here we are. So the ABV is 6.5, so it's not that 3.2 shit. It's actually twice. 3.2. And the IBUs are 30. Sounds like a good solid ballpark beer to me. You know, the piney grapefruity thing, it's pretty common in IPAs. So that's the nose. Let's give her the tongue, folks. She laces a lot better than I would have thought for an IPA, though. Salute. And I realize I'm an old guy, boomer and whatnot. I don't know why it's Tony Hawps with a P. What is a hop? Clueless, but then again, that's exactly how everybody who sees boomers is supposed to be. Of course, with boomers drink a beer, get in the back of the car, most of them wouldn't be here, so. Suck it up, buttercup. If it wasn't for us, you wouldn't even be here. Not bad. Hoppy. Go figure, it's hoppy. Hoppy, full, medium burn through the middle. As she tails off, she dries out, but she's real dirty again from all the hop oil. Not particularly bad beer. Not as good as that Tropicus was, and that Tropicus was an odd beer, but I think that's what really made the mark on it. I don't think these guys are a bad brewery. Let's call it 14. Let's go make shit up anyway. Let's make up numbers. 14. Could I drink this? Yes. Would I drink this? No, not really. I don't really favor the piney stuff. Again, not a fucking beaver. Not that I have anything against fucking beavers. You need them to build dams and stuff. Get your mind out of the gutter. You knew exactly where I was going with this, and you went the wrong way. I was going to go there, too, so it's okay. Not bad. Swing and a miss in my book, but I don't like IPAs. So, you're an IPA guy. Probably like it. I was always amazed that the big thing with the IPA guys is the alcohol count. But IPA guys don't drink Belgians, and Belgians routinely break 10. The alcohol. Always drink booze. It's not like they stop making Crown or anything. Should have a clear still in the store. You can drink booze without having it taste like booze. And you can use it to clean your carburetor, run your car, disinfect wounds. So, Everclear. In this time of plague, it's nice to have a couple of bottles of Everclear in there. Fuck, I'm pretty sure you could run a Lantern off it. Stuff's brutal. Alrighty, folks. Appreciate you swinging by. Thanks for putting some eyeballs on here. We put new guys in again. I love when we get new guys. So, new folks, welcome aboard. Glad you're here. Whichever one of your friends said, hey, you need to watch this jackass, slug them for me. Then make sure they buy you a beer. Because, you know, we're going to all suffer together, my friends. All right, I will catch you on the next review. Thanks for swinging by and putting some eyeballs on here. I appreciate it. And I want you guys to have a nice pandemic. Don't panic, man. Don't panic. Just ride it out. If you're really and truly screwed and in need and goat fucked, there are people out there willing to help you. So, like I said, just ride it out. We will catch you on the next review. So, from Pima and I, happy Metric Friday, which we just make up because that's ours, and Plague Sunday, and Pandemic of the Weekday. All right, folks. Let's go.